BMX Championships. And what a show we have today.
Absolutely fantastic. We've got five more competitors.
Here? Good crowd, yeah!
Oh.
Who we got?
Okay, we've got Simon Campbell, Britton Jones, Jason Hassel, Glenn Lewis, and George Walter.
We'll find out a bit more from George Walter. Okay, are you going to go get yourself organized?
Yep, let's go and do it. Let's get in the competition. Let's go.
Meet the judges that we've got here. Five just men, and only just. We've got Henry Gilmore, Regional Coordinator for the Northwest Region of UK BMX. Martin Higginson, the editor of BMX Freestyle magazine. Mike Pardon, BMX Beat Champion 1984, he's turned professional since then. Hey, some fans out there. Ian Tovey, member of the UK BMX National Judging Panel. And Paul Spur, board member of UK BMX. Now, would you like to get to your positions around the arena to do all the marking? In the meantime, give our judges a nice big BMX cheer, huh? Let's go over right now and join Andy for the first part of Heat 4.
Okay, first competitor, Simon Kefford, 17 years old, from Edenbridge in Kent. Remember, this is the first section of the competition, 1 minute 15 seconds of flatland routines. Awesome! And nice handlebar handstand. Nice bit of balance on the front wheel. We really have got a lively crowd today. The way to go. A lot of skill, perfecting tricks. 10 seconds left. Excellent. Nice crucifix on the bike. Okay, that's the end of the first competitor's routine. The next competitor is Winston Jones. It's not Winston Jones. It's George Gordon from Ulster. To represent the Irish riders in this competition. Nice bit of controlled riding. Quite a few freestylers in Ireland, and they're getting better all the time. And George is over here at Shaft, just how good they get. 30 seconds left. Nicely onto the front wheel. 20 seconds left. Excellent, the crowd are loving it. This is BMX Freestyle. The guys are getting warmed up. Now we're seeing some hot stuff. 5 seconds left. Nicely, a cherry picker, yeah. Okay, well done, Jules. The next competitor, this is Winston Jones. Winston Jones, 90, yes. This is what the crowd want to see, this is what the judges want to see. Nice controlled riding. And these guys are pulling off some awesome maneuvers. And nice little Miami Hopper, didn't quite hold it long enough. Very difficult to get into that trick. And infinity roll in. 30 seconds to go. Didn't quite get that, but no problem. He's keeping his cool. And he's going for it. And these two crucifix, that is hard. He needs some very strong arms, a lot of work in the gym to get to that stage. 5 seconds left. Representing the Anglo TV area. And a nice boomerang! Alright, this is what I want to see! the way to go. 30 seconds to go. And nice little cherry picker. One of the newest tricks on the BMX scene. And didn't quite get out of it like you wanted to, but it still gets some good marks. Very well performed. Excellent! Please just come up on the hill. Excellent. Takes a lot of balance. Go too far over the handlebars and it can be dodgy. 5 seconds. Quite a few years. Very experienced rider. Traveled all over the world. Nice bit of balance. Very smooth rider, yes. Very controlled. That's what the judges are looking for. Putting up some very difficult tricks here, but very well performed. And it's a nice track stand. One hand, one footed track stand. And nicely brings it up onto the handlebar. 30 seconds left, bringing the bike back over, into a handstand, awesome! Nice bit of riding by Glenn, back onto the bike, he loves it. This guy is a performer. Okay, 5 seconds. Very nice and controlled, 1 foot tackle. Okay, let's have a round of applause. We're back to the slow-mo screen. The riders absolutely love this bit. We've got Glenn Lewis here. Glenn, what do you think of the atmosphere today?
It's really magic.
Really magic. Well, they're really loving it. Okay, we're just looking at the slow-mo screen here. Now, you're doing a bit of a handstand there. How did that come about?
Well, I've got an extra bar on my handlebars, and I use it to actually sort of tip the bike down and just develop the handstand from there.
Right, is that the way you see freestyle going? You know, being more, taking more gymnastic sort of moves?
Not necessarily, but I think it's a good aspect of the sport.
Right, fantastic. Well done, Glenn. Let's go over to Alistair.
Thanks very much indeed, Andy. Now it's time for the scores, Gale, with the BMX first. Here they are, they're just ready, hot off the press. Here we go. Oh, this is exciting stuff. From 10, Simon Kefford had 149. Representing Ulster, George Gordon, 128. Representing Granada, Winston Jones with 130. Representing Anglia, Jason Hassel, 148. And last but not least, representing TVS, Glenn Lewis, with 155. So at the end of the flatland section, Glenn Lewis takes the lead.
Here in the practice arena, it's time once again for BMX Beat Teach It.
Yes, here we are.
We're going to have a wahooli today.
That's right.
Or Hawaiian, perhaps, is it?
I don't know. Let's ask him, actually.
Peppy Winder, come on down.
Yeah.
What is this? What's wahooli?
Well, basically, you ride up to the end of the ramp, stall on your back wheel, and spin your bar 360 and roll out.
And why do you call it wahooli?
There's nothing else to call it, really.
Well,
that's what we like to
do. Good answer. Okay, right, off you go. Let's see it, Peppy.
Right, okay, now this is a very difficult trick. Using a small ramp, I'm sure everybody's seen a basic ramp stall. Now, the idea is to get into a ramp stall, spin the bars. Didn't quite get it.
Try it again, Peppy.
There's a bit of a damp patch at the bottom of the ramp, which makes it a bit difficult because of the tyres.
We're trying to make it as tricky as we possibly can.
I'm going to try it again. If you notice there, he's spinning the bars right round 360 degrees and then putting his hands back on and then hopping back in.
Yeah.
So obviously its timing is very difficult. That's it!
That's the one. We get there in the end. Okay.
A wahooli stall.
Okay, let's meet Dave Young. Come on down, Dave.
All right, Dave.
Here he is. What have you got? Something else? A foot plant.
That's line up a quarter pipe, getting about halfway up, taking your foot off and just planting your foot on.
So you're
going
to be using the big ramp?
Yeah.
Hope it grows.
Off you go. Let's have a look at this one.
Okay, right. Very difficult trick again. That quarter pipe is about 8 feet high.
And it can be quite dangerous if you don't pull it off right. Now, the idea is to put your foot right on the top of the ramp, swing the bike right
very
up.
Very good.
And bring it back down
again.
See it
again? One more?
Let's go for it. One more time. Trick is self-explanatory.
Very good.
And straight back down again.
Now, of course, we've talked an awful lot about freestyle moves and so on, but also, particularly at the moment, you're getting into racing.
That's right, yeah.
What is
yeah.
The difference in attitude between doing freestyle and racing? I mean, is it like mean and moody for racing?
Right, well, yeah, it is. I mean, everybody's trying to psych out everybody else, you know, especially yeah. in the pro class, because everybody's earning their living actually racing.
What are the tricks of psyching out? I mean, what do you do?
Well, no, I mean, I'll tell you what I do. I go up on a start hill and do some freestyle tricks. I mean, that gets them down straight away.
Yeah.
That's right, because, you know, a lot of the riders I ride against, you know, yes. aren't into freestyle.
Yeah.
So I go out there and pull off, you know, like a cowboy or something like that, and they sort of go, oh dear.
And do you put yourself in a frame of mind, actually, when you get out onto the track?
That's right. Well, actually, psyching up for a race takes about a week, because you're out all week training and you've got that race in mind, so that when you get to the race, you spend all day just, you know, psyching yourself up, getting ready for it.
And what is the competition like? Is it quite, is there a lot of sort of bitchiness behind the scenes?
Well, not really, no. It's bitchy on the track, but not away from the track. I mean, the BMX racing is perhaps 60% physical and 40% mental,
yeah.
Or maybe even more. So, you know, the mental attitude plays a really big part.
You just come back from Canada, right?
That's right, yeah.
And what was the difference in attitude over there to, say, British BMX?
Well,
is that big box out there?
Well, it is. It is. It's getting that way over here. Obviously, the American pros have been riding a lot longer, and the sport itself is that much bigger because of how long it's been going. But it's not that much different. You know, the guys have just been at it longer, they're more experienced, but we're catching up fast.
Okay, we've got some more news and info for you on the next edition of BMX Beat Teaching. Join us for that. Last year's winner of BMX Beat. Welcome along.
That's
what
right,
have we
yeah.
got here?
We've got Mike Pardon with his bike and his freestyle bike, with all his equipment on it.
Yeah.
Right, basically, we're just looking at freestyle bikes and how they've developed from actual racing bikes.
What's new about this bike here?
Well, Mike, what's one of the main components on the bike that are different?
Well, with a freestyle bike here, we've got pegs for standing on the front forks, which you see a lot of the kids using them today. You know,
right, and these are actually welded onto the bike, are they?
Yeah.
They actually come with the forks.
Yeah, that's correct.
What's this little pink bit here? What's that?
That's your stem that holds your handlebars in place.
That's pretty important, isn't it?
Yeah.
But it leads down to another pink bit here, which looks very complex.
Yeah, that's your front brake, and that's got a POTS modification on, which is where the cable goes through the actual stem, you see. So that when you can spin your bars around like this, it stops your brake
right.
coming off.
Right.
Which is a good idea.
Okay, so your brakes are slightly different, aren't they, from normal brakes? Why is that? I notice they're a lot flatter on the top.
Yeah, that's right. The help with standing on and things like that, you don't get caught on your feet, and your cables are a lot, so your cable isn't sticking out there. And
I suppose the main problem is when you're spinning the bars, the normal brakes tend to hit the frame.
Yeah, that's right. So they've developed a kind of brake that goes under the frame, you see.
Are they much more expensive than normal brakes?
About the same, really. Not that much more expensive.
I'll tell you what we've got to do. We've got to move into the freestyle because all the contestants are standing by. I've been watching this. We're bringing back a few memories today, eh?
Oh, yeah.
All right, off you go freestyle.
Okay, let's do it. Okay, the first competitor, Simon Kipper from Edenbridge. All right, here he goes. This is the second section of the competition where the riders can use both ramps as well as the floor area. Here we go. It's a surfer. All right, very difficult trick. Very difficult to balance. You notice that his handlebars have got a special bit welded on, which makes it a lot easier. He can pick a platform to put his foot on. And a nice roll back. Notice his pedals. I've slipped a bit there. Notice his pedals wasn't moving backwards there. That's because he's got a toe to the brake. That means when he pedals backwards, the brake locks itself on. And a nice aerial as well. Excellent, this is what we want to see. 30 seconds left. Unfortunately, it's a fraction damp out there. We've had a few spots of rain, which doesn't help the riders at all, but the show must go on. And woo! Excellent stuff. This is Simon Kepler from Edenbridge. Likes listening to Radio 4 and gardening. Actually, I don't believe him. Woo! Stuntabiker is Jones. Jones from Ulster. George Golden. And a nice control fight for him. This guy is enjoying himself. And he's into heavy rock and Evita. Actually, I should say likes heavy rock. He's not into Evita. That could be taken the wrong way. Anyway. Now on the card here it says he admires PC McGarry. Okay, this is it. Excellent cherry picker! Remember, there's a few spots of rain, it's getting a bit slippery. But hopefully it'll hold off now. And the guys will really go for it. And a nice aerial there. But George is having fun, about 15 seconds left now. Okay, thank you very much, George Gordon, George Gordon. And the next competitor is Winston Jones. 19 years old from Manchester. And nearly pulled off 540 there. That, of course, is a very difficult trick. And nice bit of work here, up onto the bike. Twisting it round, getting in position. Nice handstand. Come on, give us some applause. Let's go. Give these guys plenty of encouragement. Okay, this looks different. Yeah! Woo! That was amazing. We haven't seen that before. That was different. This is what I want to see. This guy is really entertaining spectators here today. And a nice front wheel, 180. 30 seconds left. Nice roll back. About 15 seconds. Excellent. Nicely controlled. Not long to go now. Winston started BMX 2 years ago doing coaching for Manchester City Council. Okay, Winston Jones. The next competitor is Jason Hassel, 14 years old, from Basildon in Essex. Okay, this guy is a very smooth rider, very controlled. Pulls off some really nice tricks. Excellent! Straight back on the bike. That's what the judges are looking for. Excellent on Wilkinson. And the right hand one for an aerial. Excellent. That really is a very difficult trick. Okay, this is the full piece of BMX Beat. And we have on the floor Jason Hassel putting up a cherry picker. And didn't quite come out of it like he wanted to. Representing the Angular TV area. And Jason's advice, yes! Excellent. And his advice to beginners is look after your bike and do plenty of practices. Okay, Jason Hassel, the next competitor is Glenn Lewis. And the crowd love this guy. He's been riding BMX now for quite a long time. Travels the world doing BMX shows. One-footed kangaroo hops. Excellent. Glenn specializes in aerial work. He loves to get on them ramps. Woo! Excellent! This is what we want to see. And remember, the judges are looking for flow of the routine, degree of difficulty. Yes! Helicopter aerial. Superb stuff. One-handed aerial. Excellent. 30 seconds to go. Nicely in, onto the back wheel. And drops it nice and low, yeah! very difficult trick. Opposite one hand, one foot in aerial. Yeah! Okay! Let's have a round of applause for the competitor! Yeah! Right, here we are back with the slide my monitor. We've got Glyn Lewis again. Now, Glyn, you're doing some excellent aerials there. You specialise in aerials.
Yeah, it's my favourite trick.
So how do you practice aerials?
You start at the bottom and work your way up.
Right, but I mean, have you got a quarter pipe at home, or do you go to a local club that's got a quarter pipe?
My one's broken at the minute, so I use the local skateboard park.
Great, okay, let's take a look at the monitor. Now, you're doing a one-hand, one-footed aerial here. Have you got any other name for that?
Not really, it's just sort of my style.
Right, self-explanatory, I suppose. I mean, how would you do that? I mean, it must take a lot of practice. I mean, how did you actually work up to do that, first of all?
Somebody bet me I couldn't take my outside leg off, so I learnt it in a day.
All right, how much?
It was just a fiver, so...
All right, well, that's okay. Earn a living, I suppose, don't you?
Yeah.
Okay, thank you very much, Glyn. Over to Alistair.
Thanks very much indeed, Andy. Gail, come on over here with the final scores at the end of each four. Here we go. Representing 10, Simon Keppard had 149 in freestyle and scored 141, making a very good total, 290. Representing Austin Television, George Gordon had 128 in flatland. In freestyle, 130, making 258. Representing Granada Television, Winston Jones had 130 in flatland, 151 in freestyle, making a total of 281. Representing Anglia Television, Jason Hassel had 148 in flatland, 151 in freestyle, a total of 299, and that's the one to beat. BMX. Glyn Lewis, 155 in flatland, 156 in freestyle. The highest level so far, 311.
Excellent. Yes. Well, Glyn Lewis and Mason Smith have got the highest scores so far of the competition.
You must be highest so far. How do you fancy your chances in the final?
Yeah, I guess.
Well, keep your fingers crossed. That is amazing. The riding is just so good in this series.
It's going to be one awesome final. One more person to get.
One more person to find for that final, and that'll be happening in the next BMX Beat. But Glyn, are you going to do the lap of honour?
Go for it, Glyn.
We'll see you in the next BMX Beat. Till then. Goodbye.